are we approaching a return to normalcy here, the beginning of the end, if you will? Right now, more than 118 million people are fully vaccinated. That's more than a third of the U.S. population. Some of the 24 states that still have mask mandates are now looking to lift those restrictions. But some businesses have already said they aren't changing their rules yet. I want to bring in physician at Stanford Children's Health, Dr. Alok Patel, to break this all down for us. Dr. Patel, thanks for being here. What was your reaction to the CDC's new guidance, this announcement yesterday?
Well, I had two reactions, Diane. The first one was really applauding the underlying science and the new data about the effectiveness of vaccines, because we seem to be kind of overstepping the fact that they presented new data showing that the vaccines really do prevent symptomatic and asymptomatic infections. And also, if you're vaccinated, in the rare chance you actually get COVID-19, you're much less likely to spread it to someone else or get severely ill. But regarding the new lifting of the mask mandate and saying that vaccinated individuals can now take their masks off, hug each other, go party indoors, that seems like the CDC went from 0 to 60, in my opinion. It seems a little rushed.
And now, a big question coming out of this new guidance is, will there be some kind of vaccine enforcement, right? If you're a business, how are you supposed to handle this when there's no way to tell by looking at someone whether or not they're vaccinated?
That is a great question you pose, and it's a question that a lot of us have, and it really highlights the fact that now the onus is going to be placed on local and state leaders and all those businesses out there. As you just mentioned, 24 states still have mask mandates, and you can look at headlines right now. There's several states who have said, let's go ahead and follow the CDC's guidance, but then there's other states, Hawaii, California, you know, New Jersey, who have said, we're going to keep mask mandates in place right now. And, you know, I feel for the individuals out there who are immunocompromised, who are under the age of 12, or people who haven't been able to get vaccinated yet, and what this means about their health. Because guess what? The honor system and saying that you're vaccinated and you no longer have to wear a mask, that's not really enforceable. And I'm not sure how much a lot of people trust that. And you know that a vaccine passport probably isn't going to work in most parts of the country.
Now, the New York Yankees are also reporting an outbreak now. At least 8 fully vaccinated members, they got the J&J vaccine. They still tested positive for COVID-19. Now, their infections are mild or asymptomatic. So is this the way forward now, where we will still see outbreaks, but they'll be mostly mild or asymptomatic?
It's possible. And I want to make sure that people really understand what you just mentioned right there, is that you can still get the infection if you're vaccinated. It's not nearly as common, but you're much less likely to get severely sick. So people shouldn't be overly surprised if they see breakthrough infections. Remember, these vaccines from Johnson & Johnson, Pfizer, Moderna are all above 70 to 80% effective. That's important. And, you know, part of me also wonders if maybe the CDC should have presented this data about the effectiveness of the vaccines and then said, hey, if we reach a certain number, let's go ahead and lift those mandates maybe in a few weeks or in June, for example.
And a lot of people have been posing this question anecdotally of could they have tested positive from the vaccine, not from the virus itself? Is that even possible?
It's not. And so I will debunk two things right now. You're not going to test positive from actually getting the vaccine, because what your body is doing is making a blueprint for the vaccine, not actually making the virus itself. And also, just since we're debunking things right now, Diane, there is no such thing as shedding the virus from the actual vaccine itself. You know, as we're pushing more Americans to get vaccinated, we still need to make sure we're debunking the misinformation that seems to be spreading every single day.
I love the myth busting. I love it.
I
do have a question, though, right? I have a 2-year-old at home. A lot of people have youngins at home. I'm vaccinated, but he isn't. So I don't want to risk getting him sick. So how do parents like me handle this if we can still get sick? Is my low risk plus his low risk for being young enough, or do the rules not apply to me?
It should be enough. Now, remember, you know, I applaud you for actually doing the responsible thing and looking out for your little one. I have a newborn baby girl. I'm thinking about the same stuff right now. Mm-hmm. Now, if you're vaccinated,
congrats,
you're much less
way.
Likely. Thank you. That's why I'm sleep deprived. I don't know if you can tell. But that's also why you're much less likely to spread the virus in the rare chance you do get it. But again, I'm hearing from a lot of parents out there who are saying, hey, my elementary age child, my baby is not going to be able to get vaccinated for at least several months, if not early next year. How do we stay protected from everyone else out there who may be infected and may not be wearing a mask? And that's a big question. That's where the responsibility really does fall on the individual.
And what about the little questions, right? Like, if I were to go into a store up until today, I would take him with me. He has his mask on. Everybody else does, too. So I feel comfortable with that. But if I'm going to take him into a store where people aren't masked, that makes me a little uneasy.
And I don't blame you for feeling that. And what I would tell parents out there or someone who may not be vaccinated, if you're with someone who's immunocompromised, whatever it may be, is to think about community transmission in your area. Think about the actual business you're going to. Is it a kind of a spread out indoor, you know, farmer's market or something? Or is it a really, you know, crowded bar or restaurant? And you might want to take that into consideration about where you're going right now. And again, like we keep talking about, I think this is going to vary from state to state, you know, in New York versus San Francisco versus Alabama versus Louisiana. There's different vaccination rates. And that's what I'm seeing certain businesses, local and state leaders being paying attention to when they're deciding whether or not to lift these mask mandates. So everyone's got to do what they can to protect themselves. But I think, under again, the important thing to pay attention to is that the vaccines absolutely work. And these guidelines really do work themselves, assuming that everybody is vaccinated. So that seems to be the gap. But Americans out there should just realize that there is a reason why cases are going down right now, especially in places where vaccination rates are high.
All right, fine. So I won't take my two-year-old to a crowded bar.
Maybe not. Maybe not yet. I don't know what kind of bar. If it's like a milk bar or something, or some, you know, cool pseudo child bar I haven't been to yet, that might be okay.
We might be onto something. We'll invent that together. One more question, though, because we know that, and I hate to be the Debbie Downer here, but things are looking good in the U.S. But, you know, you look at places like India where that's not the case. We keep hearing about the potential for new, more dangerous variants. How concerned should we be about that in this context?
Well, you are not a Debbie Downer at all. In fact, you're a realistic Regina. I just made that up. But, you know, I think it's important to pay attention to the fact that, yes, things are going very well in the United States. But again, this is a global pandemic. And you can actually see in other countries such as Brazil and India what can absolutely happen if you have the combination of a lower vaccination rate plus a new variant. So even though we're lifting mandates and we're celebrating success in the United States, all it takes is a low vaccination rate in this country in some area, plus a variant or the introduction of more virus from other people, and you can absolutely have more outbreaks. We've seen this happen in the past with influenza, with measles, with whooping cough, and we can absolutely see this happen in the future with coronavirus. And so people just need to make sure that they understand what the realistic finish line really does look like. Lifting a mask mandate does not mean that we're out of the pandemic. We're still seeing thousands of Americans getting sick every day, hundreds dying, and we're seeing outbreaks all over the world.
All right, Dr. Patel, great to have you as always. Congrats again on the new baby, and whatever your tips are for hiding your sleep deprivation, we will take them all.
Bright ring lights.
Noted. Thanks, Doc.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.